aware of myself being here. So this is how most of the time we are practicing our awareness and our mindfulness. So we are trying to move ourselves from our constant thinking, overthinking, being in the past or in the future. So we try to put ourselves in the present moment. And today I want to talk about how we can practice mindfulness during the day. So we've been learning principles and pillars of mindfulness practice. There were 9 of them, and I'm going to repeat them. So 7 are very important, and 2 are more like the one that we are adding to the 7. So we end up with 9. So the first principle is non-judgmental. So we try to practice mindfulness through turning our mind into being non-judgmental. The other principle is patience. The third one is beginner's mind. 4th is non-striving. 5 is trust, which we identified as very important principle. 6 is acceptance. We accept ourselves, our environment, outside, and our state, everything, and we are moving toward the 7th principle, which is letting go. And 2 more principles was joy and kindness. And although 2 principles we are adding to the important 7, but that we talk that kind, we can say that kindness is kind of what we are building. So it's like a base, and we are building all other principles on kindness. And I want to remind you that you can think that you have to practice all of this principle at once, but remember that practicing each of this principle, they are embedded. So all of them is embedded into each of the principles. So once you start practicing non-judgmental mind, you cannot practice it without trust, acceptance, patience. So you are practicing a little bit of each principle by practicing a single one. So, and from this point, we're going to be building on our regular practice of mindfulness and how we can practice it in our everyday life or in our formal practice. So we divide our mindful practice into informal and formal. The formal one is where you can think of time you are setting yourself for meditation, for stretching, something that requires you long effort, takes you more time, and you're preparing for this, and it's a mindful practice, like going to the gym, like doing your work. So you set a time and you put more effort into this. And also your practice can be informal, and informal practice can be done during your day at any point of time. And so that's what I want to talk about today. And here we want to ask this question, like how in our day, in our week, we can practice mindfulness without any special preparation. Just be in the moment and we start practicing without changing anything, without changing anything outside. So it just requires our consistency and effort. So let's think of some of the mind experiments. Try to put aside all of the business you are doing, like everything, your tasks, your thinking. Try to put everything that consumes you aside, and in a scale of busyness, try to assess your state, like where are you at on this scale. And the scale goes from the restful laziness, like being very lazy, not doing anything, to the like busiest, rushiest time, like when you are multitasking a lot, when you're in a rush, rushed when you're very, very busy, like the extreme busyness. So try to think about where you are right now on this scale. And you can notice that in our days to be very busy, to have this heavy overload of tasks, to be in a multitasking state is very normal. It's not something that happening from time to time and something that stresses us from time to time. It's actually our daily life. So we are so busy, we are in a rush, we are overwhelmed with everything, with outside ideas, with something, someone asking us to do something, with the things that we have to do for the project, family, friends, at work. So our life is becoming busy and busy, and we think that we have to multitask a lot. And this is the idea people are living with, and they think that the multitasking, the more things they can do at once, is better. But the research and everything shows that our mind are not supposed to be working in a multitasking state. So we are more efficient and we are more effective when we are concentrating and putting our focus into the single task. We finish this task and we are moving to another one. So multitasking is actually the way to stress yourself more and not be very efficient. It just creates this idea that I'm doing a lot and that's it. It's not very effective. And like quite controversial thinking is that people can think that multitasking and being thought. So we are trying here to find a balance, to be effective and to be calm, effective and focused. And the multitasking is not the way how we are approaching the state of balance. And no matter how hard you are trying, the time is running over very fast. And it's sometimes we think that we cannot catch the time, we cannot stop the time. And the faster the tempo of our life, the faster the speed of our life, the more busier we get, the more benefits we are getting from practicing mindfulness. So for one who is not more benefits you will see from practicing increasing your mindfulness, awareness, and increasing the moments of being right now in the present moment. And the practice, the informal practice of mindfulness, doesn't take a lot of time, but it requires you patience, it requires you to be consistent, it requires your discipline, and it requires you some effort to keep yourself practicing. But it will not take a lot of time from you. So what you want to do is you want to think of the activities in your day that you are doing very automatically, like on an autopilot mode. So you're just doing them and thank you. how we can practice mindfulness and increasing our awareness of the present moment through those activities that all of us are having in our life. So let's start from the beginning of our day. And at the beginning of the day, you can, when you are taking the first glass of water, when you are having a first cup of tea, when you are having a first cup of coffee, so try to, normally you can take it and drink your first glass of water or cup of tea very quickly without thinking about something else and not being really aware of what's going on with you when you are doing exactly this activity. So, and think of when you are taking your first cup of water, you put all your awareness in this activity and you feel the heaviness of the glass, you feel the heaviness of the cup, you smell the aroma of this drink, you start taking the taking it and you feel the smell, you taste it, you notice how it's going through your body and how your state is changing. So you are noticing and being aware how you're touching the cup, how the glass is feeling in your arm. So everything, you want to experience this activity with its fullness. So another one is when you're making your bed. We all doing it very quickly. We are just doing this activity and we are thinking about something else. But what if you are, while making your bed, you are noticing how the sheets are, how you are touching the sheets, how you are feeling about doing these activities, what feelings you are experiencing through this. And you can even start saying that what you are doing right now. So for example, you can think that I'm taking this pillow and this pillow feels this and that. So you just want to experience this activity in full. When you are taking your shower, you can think of how the water is touching your skin, how the smell of the smell of any things that you are using, how the shampoo is smelling, how the conditioner is smelling. So not just doing it because you are doing it every day and thinking about something else, but fully experience it. So this experience becomes like full, like 3D experience. And that's how you are increasing your awareness of everything that's going on with you right now. Imagine you are going outside and you are taking this first fresh breath in. And you normally, we are doing it without being aware of this, but what if you put all your awareness in this first fresh breath of air and you start noticing how it feels, how this breath is going into your body and it's like nourishing you with the oxygen. And so you are doing one inhalation and exhaling, and so you are just noticing this first fresh breath of air. Another way to practice your mindfulness for the day is when you are in a line in the grocery store or in any shops, rather than browsing internet with your phone, you can just put all your awareness into your body and start noticing your breath. Take full breath in and breath out. And noticing yourself in the environment of a grocery store, not just start browsing the internet and completely fly away from the present moment. When you are walking, what if you put all your awareness into this process and you think of how your muscles is moving, like what helps you walk, how your legs are performing this activity. rather than just walking and being away with your thoughts and like just wandering and wandering a lot and not noticing what's going on, you start thinking of an activity itself and how you're performing it once and what sensation you are getting. When you are eating, what if you start trying to eat mindfully, like enjoying it, noticing the outside environment, noticing the smell, the taste, being present with your meal and experiencing fully with all sensations, like how you are digesting it. But the most important thing is that you are not doing it in a rush, but enjoying and getting the full experience. And research says that eating mindfully actually increases our satiety, and that's how we start eating less food and we don't need more because we are fully aware in this activity. So when you are greeting someone, when you are on a phone, when you are dialing the phone, so when you are in a conversation, this when you are meeting someone, so try to think of yourself like and from the outside point of view. So you are like noticing yourself in this situation, and that's how you also can bring up the awareness of present moment and practice mindfulness going through your day. When you are at the office, what you can do at the office, you can take a minute before, for example, sending some important email to someone. So you take a moment, you take a breath in, breath out, and just noticing this rather than automatically sending the email. So you're acknowledging your feelings, your thoughts, and the present moment. During the meetings, what you can do during the meetings, you can start being attentive to the point where the topic is changing. So when during the meeting the topic is changing, so you are noticing those moments, you are aware of the people who are at the meeting, and you are aware of the people who are absent from the meeting. So that's how you put your awareness from constant thinking, from constant wandering. You know yourself, a lot of time what's happening is that you are in the meeting but you are somewhere else. We want to increase your attentiveness and we want to increase experience of the present moment. When you are going home, you from your office, you want to try leave all your thoughts connected to work, maybe not every day, but even one day a week. You want to leave all your thoughts at your table, because we all know that even with our loved ones and we are with our best friends, we want some time to be apart, right? And that's how we are loving each other even more. So even with your lovely job, lovely work, you want some time to leave it at your desk and promise to be back to it next day. But you want to do it with the full awareness. And this is how you can practice mindfulness going through your day. So you can notice that there are so many opportunities to do it, and those things are not requiring you to set time for it, to prepare for it. It's just those moments during your day where you are, once you decided that you start practicing mindfulness going through the day, you just want to be consistent and you just want to be focused, and you want to practice it on a consistent basis. So here you need a lot of discipline, of course. And once, of course, at the beginning, practicing something new might be very hard, might be very challenging, but once you start doing it regularly, it becomes a habit, and then you will notice that your attentiveness to the present moment will increase in other situations. So remember, what we practice grows stronger. So once we start practicing mindfulness and awareness in those moments, like making your bed, taking a shower, you will notice that your attentiveness to the present moment, to the detail, will increase in other areas as well. And that's how the practice, the training of mindfulness will transfer to another area. So let's try right now to practice those right now in our present moment with our body. So remember, we are doing all our stretching we are doing. It's not necessarily for like exercises, but it's more for practicing present moment. So if we are stretching our neck, we are fully putting our mind, everything, our thoughts, everything into this area, and we are thinking how we are doing this. And if we are, if our mind is wandering at this point, we can say, "I am thinking," and let it go, and continue with what we are doing. So let's stretch a little bit, like move our body, and then do some breathing exercises, body scanning, and some grounding exercises. So right now, I want you to find in your comfortable position, and we start from our head. So we do, let's do today, whenever comfortable for you, because our body is different, and we all can have different areas where we have tension, and the different areas that we want to stretch. But remember, we are doing it not for the purpose of single stretching, for the purpose of muscle stretching, but more for the purpose of connecting our mind into our body. We are, this Monday morning, we are letting ourselves know that we have body, the mind, not just our head, but the whole body, the mind, the focus, the emotion, and the same thing, and the feedback. Aware that we have neck that is holding our head. So now we want to do side to side movements. And here we remind ourselves that our neck is very flexible. It can, we can look far behind our back, not just straight. And let's see how our neck is flexible, looking up and down. And up. Down, and another up and down. So now we want to move our shoulders, and here I want you to do round movement back, opening up your chest and doing this round movement with your shoulders. And now our awareness in our shoulders. We are attentive to what's going on with our body and how does it feel in the shoulder area. And we are doing round movements back. And three more. And now we are moving to do the same movements, but driving the shoulders forward. We can feel our upper back here, our shoulders, our arms, and we are noticing this part of our body. And if our mind is wandering, we are just let it go, saying, I'm thinking, and the thoughts are going away. So you are not concentrating on the exact thought, you are just reminding yourself that you are thinking. And remember that we are thinking all the time, and we want to let those thoughts go right now and concentrate on our body. Good. So now I want to do the, we would like to do the holding movement. So we open up our chest, putting our arms into our hips, and we hold this open chest position for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And now we are rounding our chest and holding it for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And now opening up our chest and holding it for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And rounding our upper back, rounding our chest, and holding this. And you want to shake your arms. And now let's put our arms up, and we are growing tall with our arms, trying to reach something up with our arms. And now we are holding one arm with another and just pulling one arm with another. And now we are doing it with another arm. And one more with the left arm and with the right arm. And let's do one more with the left and with the right. And now we are doing the same thing but in front of us, pulling the one arm with another and left and right. And remember, here we are practicing mindfulness, so it's not just the exercise itself, but more the practice of being fully in this present moment through stretching. That's why we call it mindful stretching. And another exercise you can do is you want to put your arms like this, form like a square under your head, put it a little bit behind, and you want to move one side and another side. And we are fully present in the movement we are doing. And we are noticing with all our awareness what muscle we are stretching and where we feel this more. To the left, where we want to move our spine a little bit and give it a blood flow to the lower back area. So we just do this round movement with our hips. And you might feel movement in your lower back. Another direction. We are fully aware of that we are sitting a lot during the day, and our body needs to be moving. And the spine is so important. Spine health is so important for our overall balanced health. And let's do more into other direction. And right now we want to bend forward, but do it slowly. If you can, you can reach the ground, but the most important thing is just you can slowly in. Do not try to overstretch, just how your body allows. And relax, just kind of feel your arms, everything very relaxed. And slowly go back. And you can do the opposite movement just to balance. And one more. Forward. Relaxing your upper body and back. Okay. So now we want to move our knees a little bit. So you are putting all the weight on the left feet, bending your right leg, and just moving. And let's do it with another leg. The right leg balance is not so good today. Okay, let's move our legs a little bit. So right now it feels like all our body, we are aware that we are having our legs, our torso, our shoulders, our chest, our neck, and our head. So should be feeling very balanced and aware that we are our body. Let's try to practice some focused and balanced movement. So you want to put all your weight onto left leg, just move your leg, right leg up, and just hold this position and balance it out. So we know that even when we are shaking, we can concentrate and we can balance it out. Let's hold this position for 5 more seconds. And notice what helps you keep this balance. Where is your concentration? Where is your focus? How you are focusing and how you are concentrating and keeping this balance. Let's do another leg. It might feel easier or harder to do to practice the balance another leg, and that is also deep interesting. Noticing this difference is also very interesting. So, and try to notice what helps you practice balance here on this leg. Let's keep it for 5 more seconds. And relax. And now when we practice balancing and we know that when we are shaking, we need to just keep our focus, keep our concentration on the things we want to. So we want to balance grow. We keep concentration on the things that helps us to grow our balance. And in daily life, it can be anything, just try to notice it and concentrate and focus on those things. So you, right now, you can close your eyes or keep your eyes open, and you can keep your feet on the shoulder width or put them together. When we stretched and kind of went through our body, now we are putting all our awareness in our legs, in our feet, and we are noticing the surface where our feet is touching the ground, and we are imagining that we are growing the roots, and our legs are so strong, they keep us standing, and we are growing our roots stronger and stronger, and we grounding ourselves through those roots, and we feel more stable, more grounding, more calm, and nothing can shake us. So nothing can interfere with our feeling of ground. So nothing can interfere with our feeling of balance, calmness, and feeling grounded. Because the roots we are growing through our feet is so strong, they are keeping us balanced and grounded. And from our feet, we start just scanning our body up, going through our feet to our knees, toward our hip area, torso, our chest. We are moving up to our chest, our shoulders, our neck. Everything is relaxed. And if you are feeling tension in any parts of your body, just try to relax it with saying that. If you are feeling the tension in your left arm, you're just saying that my left arm is feeling relaxed. My body is feeling relaxed. And we are moving toward our face, toward our head. You can notice that your jaws are very intense, and you are just saying to yourself, my face is relaxed. And now you start noticing your breath, how you are normally breathing without changing it. Remember, our breathing happening voluntarily. We are not doing anything. It's our body keeping us alive. Every second, every moment. And how wonderful is that? No matter what is happening, we are alive. Our breath is take a full breath in and breath out. And if your breaths were short and you're breathing through your chest, try to do full breath with expanding your belly, moving your diaphragm, expanding it, and reaching yourself with oxygen and breathing out. Breathing in and breathing out. Breathing in and breathing out. You notice how calm and steady your breath right now. Breathing in and breathing out. Let's take 5 more full breaths in and out. Breath in and out. Breath in. In, breath out, and another one, breath in, breath out. Keep breathing, even though you cannot stop it, but try to breathe with a relaxed pace. And let's move our arms up through the sides with another breath in and move them down. Move our arms up with another breath and down. Move our arms up with another breath and down with the next breath. And then connect our arms together on the level of our chest. Let's create some heat with our arms. And when we feel warm, you can put your arms into your eyes, feel this warm, your arm, warmness with your arm touching your eyelids. And when you are releasing your arms, you can open your eyes and start being aware of the outside environment. And I hope when you open your eyes, you are opening it with a changing state. And remember always that this is how in 5 minutes you can change your state going through your day. So with all these easy, simple techniques, but the one that requires the best discipline, the one that requires practice, you can always change your state. And we are always shaking, we are, something throw us out of the balance. We are, from time to time, we are feeling not very grounded, but we are in charge of changing our state with breathing, with concentration, with focus, with growing roots through our legs, grounding ourselves, practicing mindfulness, going through the day in our daily activity. We can bring the balance in our life. We are not afraid of being out of balance. It's life, it's happening. It's the training for our system. It trains us how we are, it trains our ability of bringing the balance back. So not those shaking situations are bad, or we don't want them to happen. They are good because they are training our ability to bring the balance in our life. So please keep practicing mindfulness through your daily activities, the one that you are normally doing, like in an autopilot or in automatic state. With the habit you developed for a long time, right now, this week, and other weeks following, try to put more awareness and mindfulness into those activities and raise your attentiveness in other areas. I'm very thankful, very grateful for you to changing your state, knowing, being aware how we can change the state going through the day. And I wish you all a wonderful, mindful, full of mindfulness experience, day, week, every moment. Although every moment cannot be mindful, but the more we practice it, the stronger it grows. So I'm very thankful for all of you coming, and I'm wishing you an amazing day and amazing week. And see you next Monday with another beautiful practice. So thank you very much, and bye bye everyone.